The sound of your voice starts in your voice box. Within the voice box, there are two stretchy bands of tissue known as vocal cords, which vibrate against each other, creating sound whenever you talk. Women generally have thinner, shorter, and tighter vocal cords than men. And so, just like a high-pitched violin string, female vocal cords vibrate faster, creating a higher-pitched voice. That sound is called the vocal fundamental frequency. On its own, it is just a simple buzzing sound. But when it reaches your vocal tract, the sound waves start bouncing around. Those reflections interfere with each other, which creates a mix of other frequencies, resulting in your very own unique voice. So even though your voice starts out as one frequency, it ends up as a mix of multiple ones that you can detect with a spectrogram. This is where helium comes into play. Helium is lighter than air, which means sound moves faster through helium than through air. Nearly three times faster, in fact. So the sound waves bounce around faster in your vocal tract, which amplifies the higher frequencies in your voice.
Ooh, I sound funny now.
Instead of helium, if somebody sucks in sulfur hexafluoride, which is six times heavier than air,
the sound waves would move slower through it, amplifying the lower frequencies in your voice.
But here's the fascinating thing. The pitch of your voice hasn't changed when you inhale either gas, because your vocal cords move at the same rate, no matter what gas you're breathing. So your fundamental frequency stays the same, regardless of whether you sound like Mickey Mouse.